Fine, I think all of you have joined back. As soon as everyone joins, Rashmi ma'am, just allow me to share the screen.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, you share the screen, then I can mute them, sir. Then also, those who are
okay, yeah. Okay, this was the one where we already have just three participants so far. Others can also join in. Yeah, you just go to joinmyquiz.com and you enter this code 792127. Are others joining? Please, I don't see more people joining here. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay. Kindly join quickly. Just fill in your browser, joinmyquiz.com, and enter this code. It's very simple. Yeah, we have now more people joining in. It would be fun to observe how the students, they actually do it. ये मेरे को वो साइड का चैट बॉक्स में इसको फुल स्क्रीन एग्जिट करके शॉर्ट में लेना चाहती हूँ तो क्या करूँ इसको
नीला मैम यू आर म्यूटेड
ओके थैंक यू ओके सो आई सी 13 पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी जॉइंड सो शैल वी स्टार्ट द गेम इज देयर एनीवन हु इज स्टिल ट्राइंग टू जॉइन और आई विल स्टार्ट ओके लेट मी स्टार्ट देन If others in the meanwhile, you can note the code 792127 and you can join anytime if you're still trying to join. So let's start.
Aramwala. Sir, loko maine join karla pare, sir, do jante.
Great, great going. We have 73% accuracy. That's how the students get to know all those who are responding. Your speed also matters. Here you can see the way you answer, it is coming here. So Chavi ma'am has completed the quiz, so has Amrita ma'am, Isha ma'am close to it. Yeah, quickly please. So we can see most of the people, they have completed the quiz. So I'll just wait for 1 minute more and we'll end the quiz, whatever answers you have given. Okay. So here you can see the accuracy level also along with. Okay. So just in 5 seconds, I am going to end now. Okay, I'm going to end it now. Right? Let me finish. Most of the people have already answered. So it is, I go to this right hand top corner and end. Okay, this is the end. So this is the result. Wow, Isha ma'am is first, Chavi ma'am is second, and Mr. Sanjeev Kumar is third. Wow, that was great. So this is the podium, right? And these are the people who scored 100%. So we have so many. So we had a brilliant class that scored so much. So this is how the students also enjoy this. So we can have the overview of how you played. If somebody had gone wrong, then what was the wrong answer? And how much was the time taken by every person? Say, for example, Rakhi Mathur ma'am, you took just 5 seconds to answer this. Or we can say Isha Gold ma'am, all of them, they have answered it correctly because she was very quick in answering. So she has got the top position. The students also build up their speed by doing so. So this is how we can do it. The students really have the fun, and we can analyze the questions also one by one with them. Which of following are covered under the domestic territory of India? Say, the correct answer was Google Office in India. Now we get to know that if there are 17 players, out of them, 12 got it right and 5 got it wrong. In the class, you might be knowing who has got wrong. If you want to discuss openly, then you can go here, who all went wrong with which particular question. So we can analyze each and every question this way, which is the example of transfer income. Out of this, unemployment allowance is the transfer income. Now we have got 13 people saying the correct answer and 4 got incorrect. Similarly, this question, 15 correct entries and 3 incorrect. And we can get the student-wise analysis also. So students really enjoy, and this is so quick to make the quiz so that you don't have to plan much about it, and instantly the quiz would be ready. I hope you have got all the points that how the quiz can be created and how it can be played. Once you do it yourself, you are really going to enjoy, and your classes will become much more interesting, and the students, they really look forward to that what kind of game we are going to play today or what we will be having today. So I hope the tools that you have learned today, you will be using them, those tools in your classes, and you will be using them further to generate interest among the students. Thank you so much for attending this webinar. And if you want to download your certificates of participation, already the link is there. So you can have the link from there. It's there in the chat box. And if you have any queries, either you can ask right now if you have any query, or you can put the queries in the webinar group so that we can answer it over there. This group will remain live for the next 2 days. So if you have any queries right now, you can ask. Once you practice this, when you have it hands-on, still if the doubts arise in your mind, you can put those questions there. But I'm sure you are going to try these techniques in your class, and you will have fun with them, and the classroom would be more effective, because online teaching, you see, it is going to stay here for a while. As we can see the situation, third wave is already predicted, vaccination drive is full on. So till the time it takes time, so we are going to have the online teaching, and we can take it as a blessing in disguise, because these are the things which we can have only in the online classroom. Maybe in the actual classroom, we don't have these tools. Then we have to follow our own traditional lecture method where we don't have access to all these techniques, or maybe not on daily basis, because we can't allow the students to carry the laptops on daily basis or mobile phones, which are strictly prohibited in the school. So let's have more fun with the students so that we have the privilege of online teaching. Thank you so much, all of you, for joining this webinar. Yeah, and at the same time, I would like to thank Matthew sir for creating and sharing this platform. It's a wonderful platform that all of us can exchange our ideas. Thank you, Deepika ma'am, for volunteering to be the resource person, and Rashi ma'am, Deepika ma'am's insight, especially the 3E strategy. I think that is very, very useful to encourage, to engage, and to be effective in the class. I think that in nutshell tells us what should be the spirit in the class. And Rashi ma'am, the tool that you taught, I find it really so interesting. I just learned it today. So I'm definitely going to apply it in the class, because students, I see most of the time, you must have seen at your home, if you are the parents of that age group, that the students log in, get their attendance mark, and then they are loitering around, or sometimes they fall asleep also. Unless until they have some active thing to engage themselves with. So finally, thank you everyone. Anyone, if you wish to ask anything, now you can unmute yourself and you can ask. I think everyone is satisfied.
Good evening, ma'am. It was really a satisfactory webinar. I am so grateful to be here a part of this webinar, and I am definitely going to add these techniques in my classroom. Just a suggestion or just a request, if you can be like this recorded video can be shared in the group so that we can go step-wise. Right now we have not went with the step-wise, so that we can practice and share with the students also how we can do this technique in the classroom.
Thank you so much. This video will soon be shared in the group that has been created, the group where the link was posted. In the same group, this video will also be shared. So you
thank
can
you
go
so
step
much,
by step at that pace. I'm sure once you try it yourself, you are going to enjoy these tools. It might take once or twice, but once you familiarize yourself, it would be really fun. I think now the focus is on education. In the times to come, maybe CBSE is going to change the pattern of evaluation also forever. Because seeing that one, we cannot depend on one examination. So let's focus that the students understand the concept rather than they know how to attempt a 3-marker or a 4-marker or a 6-marker. So let's focus on their learning. And with these techniques, they learn in a fun way. So either through their newspaper sharing, as Deepika ma'am said, that give them real life examples, or the tool which was shared by Rashi ma'am, that have the some kind of activity so that they know they have to quickly answer, or in case of quizzes, we can have
Very right, Sunila ma'am. The focus has to be on fun learning, flipped classroom, and a subject like economics can be made really very, very absorbing. Once they stop dreading the subject, they'll start loving the subject.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyone has any questions you have?
Good evening, ma'am. I'm Abhishek from Allahabad. Ma'am, I want to next webinar, if possible, related with the statistics part. Whenever we teach, taught in the class 11th also, regarding arithmetic, mean, median, mode. We want next webinar on that particular topic also, so we are able to cope up very much with our learners and the stakeholders. It's my quiet request to you, the next time, whenever it is possible, you kindly arrange the webinar for that topic also.
Sure, Abhishek sir. I think all of you have filled in the feedback form. What would you like
yes,
to be
yes,
the
yes,
topic
yes.
of the next
already,
webinar?
Ma'am, already filled up.
So,
already filled up, yeah.
So we'll go by majority.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
If you want class 11th topics, we'll take up 11th class topics. If you want, in the times to come, if we can hold them more frequently, so we can take it topic wise also, we can take it more tools also. We can
actually, ma'am, in the class 12 economics, national income, multiplier, aggregate demand are the first topics which contain special parts also. No? But 11th, the statistics part also is a very much for the students also,
yeah.
So that we can
especially the students who
them.
Don't have maths, they dread statistics.
Yeah, they are especially
the students
who opt
for economics, they have the maths. But if somebody doesn't have maths, then they find statistics somewhat difficult. So definitely, sir, we will consider your feedback and we will act on it.
Any more
questions?
Thank you so much.
Excuse me, ma'am. Thank you for such a wonderful session. This is Amrita Jogani from Bangalore. It's just related to the subject, just as ma'am said that some students do not take up mathematics and they find it to be really difficult. I had a student who was a pure humanities student, but she happened to love the subject, by the end of grade 12. And now when she wants to pursue further, she's finding it difficult because she does not have the combination of mathematics. So if you can please pour in your suggestions, it will be really great.
Shall I?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
The requirement of having maths with economics for especially pursuing eco honors, this is not so in all the universities. You are from Bangalore, you said? You are from
yes,
Bangalore?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Amrita ma'am, I'm not sure about what the universities over there are offering for. In DU, in Delhi University, yes, it is the requirement that if you want to go for economics honors, then maths is compulsory subject. But it is not so, I know, in Bombay University. If in Bangalore, if I am right, I think in Christ, they don't ask for this requirement because they have different kind of combinations. They have two majors or three majors.
All science
in certain
and
universities. Yeah. In certain universities, it is the requirement if the child had not pre-decided, although I think it's always advised that a student who is opting for economics should always also take up maths. But in case the student develops the liking later on, after studying it for 2 years and still they want to go for economics, then they should look for the universities where this requirement is not there. And I'm sure you will find a number of universities which do take economics graduates without having the maths foundation.
Yeah.
You just have to broaden your search for that.
Yeah. Actually, the student was more interested in DU. That is why the question, ma'am.
DU doesn't permit it. But in Delhi, there are other universities which do. There is a Ambedkar University which does. DU doesn't. DU is a central university. DU doesn't permit.
Thank you so much for clarifying it.
Even Symbiosis University offer eco honors without maths.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, I think there are no more questions. Then we can end the meeting.
We can end the meeting on a peaceful note. It was quite noisy in the beginning.
In between, it was noisy.
I don't know. Somebody, we have to.
Anyways,
I have to really check the recording as well.
Yeah. Okay.